Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install NeoVim editor and how to configure it on our Windows operating system. So do watch the video till then. I can guarantee if you watch the video till then, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And I really love reading all of your comments. So please do comment on our comment sections if you are really liking this video. So let's set a target of about 100 comments under this video. Now, as you know that NeoVim is popularly used on Linux environment, but you can also use it on Windows. So that is what I'm going to show you on this video. So let's jump in into our Chrome browser and open a new tab and just simply type NeoVim download. So just simply go to their official site. Here you need to just simply click on install now. Here if you scroll down, you will get, you know, all these different ways to install Neo on your system. So that's the install procedure for Windows. I'm going to use the actual MSI, but you can always use some different ways from different package managers like Wingate, Chocolate Tea, Scoop and all that. And if you are using it for different operating system like macOS or Linux, so you can always refer to all these different links. Alright, so for Windows, that is what topic of this video, you know, install from download, and here is a Windows link, so you need to click on that. So immediately you will see MSI file getting downloaded over here, right? So NVim win64.msi is just 11 MB file. So once when it get downloaded, just simply click on that installer. So welcome to NeoVim setup, click on next, accept the license agreement, you must read this, click on next, and this is where our NeoVim is going to be installed, totally fine, click on next, and ready to be installed, click on install. So it's going to ask you for administrative privileges, click on yes, and our NeoVim is rightly started installing. And there you go. So our NeoVim is rightly installed, click on finish. So now if you jump over to command prompt, and if you just simply type NVim and hit enter, you are going to get this type of prompt. So if you are getting this type of prompt, then all that basically means is your NeoVim or NVim is rightly installed on your system. Now we need to configure a bit. You can see we don't have any line numbers and all those stuffs. So let's first terminate from here. So hit enter. Let's close this also and quickly go to run. So window R. So here let's quickly go to app data. So percent app data percent and just simply enter. So that's going to open this app data roaming folder, go our directory back, and you will get a local folder over here. So just go inside. And here if you scroll down, you can't see any NVim folder, right? We only have this NVim data. So, you know, let's create a NVim folder. So right click new folder and let's name it as NVim. Hit enter and go inside. And here we need to create a config file. So let's right click and create a new text document and let's name this text document as init. And let's remove this txt to vim. Hit enter. Do you want to file name extension? Yes, we want to change it. So now it is a vim. Let's open it in a notepad and here we are going to write config. So I have already written a very simple config. You are going to get that on our GitHub account. So this link also I'm going to provide right in our channel description. So I'm going to just simply copy this basic stuff. So it has line number, relative number, tab stop, then shift width, all those things. So I'm going to just copy it and paste it over here and click on save. So now let's close this and again close this NVim folder as well. And now let's really use it for a Python program. So let's create something like Python demo and let's open a command prompt right at this location. And here if you just simply type NVim and hit enter, so that's going to open our NVim right at this location. And now you can see we have a line number written over here, right? So you can, you know, write simple Python programs. So let's print something first, like let's say print hello world, and let's also add couple of numbers. So let's say equal to 5, b equal to let's say 6, and let's, you know, print summation of these two numbers, so a plus b. All right so this is our very simple Python program. So let's save our file. So just escape and just simply type colon w and then give your file name. So let's give the file name as test.py and hit enter. So that's going to save our file. You can see our file is rightly saved over here. Now let's run it. So give colon then explanation python space percent. So percent basically means that we are telling Vim to execute the current selected file. So hit enter and there you go, you can get the output, right? So hello world and then 11. So that's how you use NeoVim or NVim on Windows operating system. Do mention on our comment sessions if you need a detailed video on how to configure this NVim for Windows. I'm going to happily make a very detailed video on that as well. And I am making lot of videos on Python, so I'm sure you're going to love this cool Python project playlist. So yeah, so that's pretty much all about this video. Please do mention and show us some love on our comment sessions. I really love reading all of your comments. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.